Chapter 8, Learning Objective 4, Utilize Effective Complaint Procedures. This probably will happen to you more often than you would hope in your life, but many times there's a problem with the purchase, and you need to go about it in the right way if you want to achieve satisfaction with your purchase. Redress is the process of righting a wrong. The FTC, as I mentioned previously, has a cooling off rule that allows you 3 days to cancel purchases of $25 or more made anywhere other than the dealer's usual place of business. So, in most cases, when we're buying a vehicle, that would not apply because you're making the purchase at the dealership. So, you know, I would guess if you bought it online from an online dealer, they would make the same argument. It's that there is a usual place of business for the dealer. So, the cooling off rule, I believe it was originally created for, like, you know, door-to-door salesmen and so forth, individuals that came to your home and used high-pressure sales tactics to get you to purchase things. So that definitely does not apply to any purchase made at the dealership. So. Alternatives to dispute resolution. Mediation and arbitration. The difference between the two, mediation is a recommendation, arbitration is binding. So you need to be aware of those when you are negotiating. If you agree to arbitration, you are agreeing to abide by the arbitrator's decision. Lemon laws are a form of arbitration, but they're only binding on the dealer. So, I believe the way lemon laws work, if a vehicle is in the shop for either three or four times over a 12-month period and the problem is not fixed, the lemon laws apply. Only applies when the vehicle is under warranty. Small claims court is another option. You can go into small claims court and file a claim. And in most cases, you would represent yourself and the court decide whether you were entitled to compensation or some form of reparations. The complaint procedures. Where are you going to bring your complaint? First place, you're going to start at the dealership, local business. Then you go to the manufacturer. Then you go to self-regulatory organizations, consumer agencies, and then small claim for civil court. Concept check 8.4, so outline the steps to go through to seek redress. We just covered that, local business, manufacturer, self-regulatory organizations, consumer action agencies, and small claims or civil court. So summarize the FTC's cooling off rule to cancel a contract. Allows you 3 days to cancel purchases of $25 or more made anywhere other than the dealer's usual place of business. Distinguish between mediation and arbitration. Mediation is non-binding. Arbitration is binding. How do lemon laws work? Lemon laws vary, but common rule is the vehicle is in the shop for the same, was in shop for the same repair during the first year. I believe it's three times, it may be four times, but they would apply. The laws provide guidelines for an arbitrator to issue an order for dealer buyback, which means a dealer buyback would be a specified price that the dealer was ordered to pay you. Again, it is binding on the dealer, it is not binding on you. So if you're not happy with the price, if that's being offered, you can decline. The dealer does not have that option. So, conclusion for Chapter 8, worst blunders in vehicle and other major purchases. Tell a seller what you can afford to pay. This, you know, walk into a dealership and you tell them I can afford $500 a month. I can assure you that you will not get the best deal. That's an understatement. Rely solely upon the seller for information on price, financing terms, and trade-in value. You got to do your homework. You got to be prepared. Dealerships are there to make money, so you have to be prepared and be able to negotiate your own deal. You can't expect them to give you that the best deal. Fail to complain when products fail to perform as expected. Now do it now. Set up a filing system for warranty information, receipts for all products that you own that have a warranty. Two, decide on big ticket item you would like to own in the near future. Create decision making worksheets similar to Table 8.2 using your own criteria and weights. Number three, keep a monthly budget. Fit all the payments for big ticket items into your budget before making the purchase decision.